愿大家平安。
Peace be with everyone。
今天下午跟大家一起来学习与主耶稣同死同活。
So for the topic of this afternoon, we'll be studying dying and living with Christ。
我们信耶稣受洗以后要怎么生活
？So when we believe in Christ after baptism, how do we live？
这是非常重要的一个题目，我们需要思考。
This is a very important topic or idea that we have to reflect on.
那我们要决定我们怎么生活，我们先要了解信耶稣在受洗的时候到底发生了什么事情。
So to decide how we want to live, we have to really think about what is exactly happening with us and Jesus when we are baptized.
我洗礼以前跟洗礼以后到底有什么不同。
Comparing the myself before a baptism and myself after baptism, is there any difference?
那如果我们了解这个不同那我们就知道我们的生活也会不一样。
So if we can notice this difference, then we will realize that our lives will be changed.
首先洗礼以前，我们到底我们这个人在神看起来是怎么样一个人？
So first, before baptism, as a person, how exactly does God view us?
我们来看以弗所书。
Let's turn to the book of Ephesians.
以弗所书。
Ephesians.
以弗所书第二章。
Ephesians chapter 2.
第二章的第一节。
Ephesians chapter 2, verse 1. Verse 1, and you he made alive, who were dead in trespasses and sins.
好，这个地方讲你们死在过犯罪恶之中。
So here it says, you who were dead in trespasses and sins.
然后主耶稣叫我们活过来。
And in the beginning it says, and you he made alive.
所以受洗这是一种过程。
So baptism is a process.
我们活在地面上如果没有活就没有死。
So on this earth, if you don't live, then there is also no death.
但是在灵界里面我们没有经历过死亡，我们就没有永远的生命。
But spiritually, if we have not gone through that death, then we cannot obtain that life.
这个死在过犯当中到底怎么一回事？
So what does it mean when it says that you were dead in trespasses?
如果我们从第二节来看。
Let's take a look at verse 2.
请。
Verse 2. In which you once walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit who now works in the sons of disobedience.
第三节。
Verse 3. Among whom also we all once conducted ourselves in the lusts of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh, and of the mind, and were by nature children of wrath, just as the others.
这个第二节就在讲还没有洗礼前我们的生活方式。
So in verse 2, it talks about our life before we are baptized.
行事为人随从今世的风俗。
We walked in according to the course of this world.
这个今世的风俗是什么？
So what exactly is the course of this world?
也可以讲文化，也可以讲传统，也可以讲潮流。
It could be different cultures, traditions, or influences.
所以我们在世界上随着世界的文化、传统、潮流在生活。
So while we are on this world, there is a possibility of being influenced by the cultures and traditions of the world.
那这个有什么不好？
So what exactly is bad about this?
如果我们看那个文化、传统、潮流的后面是什么？
What exactly is? We have to look at what exactly is behind the cultures and traditions.
下面说顺从空中掌权者的首领这个空中掌权者的是什么？
So here it says, according to the prince of the power of the air. So who exactly is this prince?
空间掌权者就是魔鬼
The prince of the power of the air is Satan.
所以当然文化传统有一些是很好的。
So some cultures and traditions may be good.
但是它的整个大方向是要引导我们离开神。
But the general direction of all these traditions is to guide us away from God.
它是要让我们继续活在罪里面。
These traditions want us to continue to live in sin.
所以魔鬼没有直接显现，魔鬼借着文化传统潮流在带领我们，在控制我们。
Satan doesn't just directly show himself, but rather he uses the different traditions of the world to slowly influence us.
哦，所以下面说，这个在啊，现今悖逆之子心中运行的灵。
That's why it says afterwards, the spirit who now works in the sons of disobedience.
哦，所以为什么这么多人很难信耶稣？
So why is it so hard for so many people to believe in Christ?
因为那里面有一个灵在工作。
Because within them, there's this spirit that is working in them.
啊，这个叫做悖逆之子运行的灵，就是魔鬼的灵。
And this is called the spirit of the sons of disobedience, which is also Satan's spirit.
哦，所以一个人要信耶稣，这是一种征战。
So for someone to believe in Jesus, this is a type of battle.
哦，他要从魔鬼的带领、魔鬼的内工作之中啊，要从那里出来。
And what they have to do is to get out of this control from Satan.
啊，然后为什么这个世界文化潮流啊很吸引人？
So why is it? Why is the traditions and cultures of the world so enticing?
啊，如果我们看第三节。
If we take a look at verse 3.
啊，说我们以前啊，还没有信耶稣以前啊，就是在他们中间放纵肉体的私欲。
So in the beginning it says, whom we all once conducted ourselves in the lust of our flesh.
所以在这个世界里面没有讲说要节制这一句话。
So in the world it doesn't talk about cleansing or purifying.
哦，你有什么欲望，你尽情去享受。
If you have any desires, you should go and fulfill it.
哦，然后心中所喜好的去行。
And fulfilling the desires of the flesh.
哦，我们心里想什么，我就去做。
Whatever our heart desires, we go and do it.
所以啊，魔鬼借着罪的欲望啊，在控制我们。
So Satan uses the desires of sin to control us.
哦，那这样的生活方式啊，我们变成可怒之子。
So this type of lifestyle is also known as the nature of children of wrath.
啊，也就是说，在神面前我们犯了罪，继续停留在罪里面，在公义的神面前，其实我们是敌人的。
So if we still have sin, then before the just God, we are actually his enemies.
哦，然后我们人生的转变点在哪里？
So where exactly is the turning point in our lives?
啊，如果我们看第四节。
Let's take a look at verse 4. Verse 4. But God, who is rich in mercy, because of his great love with which he loved us.
啊，第五节。
Verse 5. Even when we were dead in trespasses, made us alive together with Christ, by grace you have been saved.
啊。所以第五节讲啊，我们在过犯中是死的状态。
So in verse 5 it says even when we were dead in trespasses.
啊，那神叫我们与基督一同活过来。
We were made us alive together with Christ.
这是什么？洗礼啊。
So what exactly is this? This is baptism.
哦，所以没有洗礼之前呢、啊。
So before baptism.
我们肉体是活着。
Our flesh is living.
哦，但是灵里面是死的。
But spiritually, we're actually dead.
哦，所以我们是活的死人。
So we are a living dead person.
哦，所以我们跟没有洗礼的人差在哪里？
So what difference do we have with other people who aren't baptized?
没有洗礼是活的死人。
If you are not baptized, then you are a living dead person.
他没有属灵的生命。
You don't have any spiritual life.
啊，那在洗礼就产生很大的改变了。
So after baptism, you go through a great transformation.
哦，洗礼以后我们属灵的生命就活过来。
So after baptism, your spiritual life will be, you'll be alive again.
所以我们肉体是活着，但是我们在灵里面也活着。
So in our flesh, we're still living, and spiritually, we're also living.
为什么洗礼我们在那个海边啊，机场那个海边下水浸一下，功效这么大呢？
So why do we go all the way to the ocean, next to the airport, and we baptize people in the water, and this is so effective.
好，我们现在看啊，罗马书的第六章。
Let's take a look at Romans chapter 6.
啊，罗马书的第六章。
Romans chapter 6.
第六章的第三节。
Romans chapter 6, verse 3.
啊，请读。
Verse 3. Or do you not know that as many of us were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death?
啊。好，再看第四节。
Verse 4. Therefore we were buried with him through baptism into death, that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in newness of life.
这个第六节就在讲啊，洗礼就是归入主耶稣的死。
So in chapter 6, it talks about how if we we were baptized into in verse 3 it says we were baptized into his death.
Oh. 那这个是什么意思?
So what exactly does this mean?
如果我们看第四节,
let's take a look at verse 4.
接着洗礼归入他的死和他一同埋葬。
It says, therefore we were buried with him through baptism into death.
我们知道主耶稣死在十字架上。
So we all know that Jesus died on the cross.
然后在十字架上流出他的宝血。
And while he was on the cross, he shed his precious blood.
要死以前他讲成了。
And before he, before he passed, he said, it is done.
到完成什么?
So what was done?
因为马太福音第一章主耶稣还没有出生以前天使就告诉 约瑟,
because in Matthew chapter 1, before Jesus was born, an angel told Joseph,
说玛利亚生一个儿子,
the angel said, Mary will be, will have a son.
你要把他取名叫做耶稣,
and you must call this child Jesus.
然后他要把人从罪里面救出来,
and he will be the one to save mankind from sin.
所以主耶稣来世界33年只完成一件事情。
So the Lord Jesus was down here on this earth 33 years to accomplish one thing.
把人从罪里面救出来,
to take out mankind from sin.
因此主耶稣在他人生的最后一个礼拜,
so up to the point where it was the last week of Jesus' life,
圣经说他面向耶路撒冷,
the Bible said that Jesus faced towards Jerusalem.
他好几次告诉门徒, 我要再死在耶路撒冷。
And for many times, he already told disciples, I will be dying in Jerusalem.
我三天要复活。
And in 3 days, I will be resurrected.
如果我们今天有人告诉你, 你到, 旧金山的市区, 你会死在那里, 请问你会去吗?
So today, if someone said that, oh, you will be going to San Francisco, and that is the place of your death, would you go there right now?
我没有人愿意去啊, 我死在那里, 我怎么愿意去?
None of us would be willing to go there. Why would you go to a place that you would die in?
但是如果我们被勉强去,
but if we were forced to go,
可能我们是一直去一直流眼泪, 赶快想办法要溜走,
we might be going in tears, and we might be planning an escape.
但是主耶稣面向耶路撒冷一步一步一直往前走。
But Jesus faced Jerusalem, and with every step of the way, he continued forward.
他没有逃避,
and he never fled.
他只求神加添他的力量,
he only asked God to give him more strength.
因为他知道这个神要叫他走的路。
Because he knew that this was the path that God told him to go on.
那这一条路叫做喝苦杯。
And this path is also known as drinking the bitter cup.
也就是被钉在十字架上。
Which is to be nailed on the cross.
那十字架旁边两个强盗。
So on the cross, beside Jesus were two robbers on his side.
这个两个强盗，他们也讲啊，我们今天被钉十字架，这个是我们最应该得的。
And these two robbers said that for us to be on this cross, it is deserving of us.
所以他知道啊, 罪的结果就是被刑罚。
So they knew that the punishment for this is the punishment for sin.
但是主耶稣本身没有罪啊。
But Jesus himself didn't have any sin.
那他为什么被钉在跟强盗钉在一起?
So why was he nailed on the cross next to the two robbers?
就是要为罪人付出赎价。
Because he was willing to pay the price for all mankind and sinners.
你跟我们都是罪人。
You and I are all sinners.
跟世界上人一样。
We're the same as the people of this world.
那罪人的结果应该是跟强盗一样。
And the result of sin was supposed to be just like the robbers.
不但要死, 而且被咒诅。
And not only die, but also curse.
那今天主耶稣已经为我们上了十字架。
But today, Jesus has already gone up the cross for us.
付出罪人应该的代价。
And he has already paid the price that we as sinners are supposed to pay.
所以主耶稣在十字架上流出最后一滴血。
So the Lord Jesus on the cross shed his last drop of blood.
成了。
And it is done.
救恩完成了。
Salvation is done.
怎么完成?
So how is it done?
就是他流出他的宝血, 成为赦罪的泉源。
He was able to shed all his blood to create this living fountain of life.
那主耶稣断气的时候, 那个圣殿, 分开至圣所, 那个幔子就裂开来。
So when Jesus took his last breath, the temple's curtain broke in two.
因为至圣所有神的同在。
Sorry, torn in two, and this is because the temple had the presence of God.
那是人没有办法进去的。
And this is the place that no man could go in.
只有大祭司一年带一次血能够进去的。
Only the high priest could enter to sacrifice.
但是主耶稣为我们付出了赎价之后，人跟神的关系就打开了。
But once the Lord Jesus died on the cross for us, the relationship between man and God has been, formed.
那个主耶稣流出来的宝血就在洗礼的时候要洗掉我们的罪。
So this precious blood that Jesus has shed during his death is the baptism that can wash away our sins.
所以如果我们回到罗马书的第六章。
So if we return back to Romans chapter 6.
第四节。
Verse 4.
第三节啊。受洗是归入他的死。
Verse 3 says, as many of us were baptized into Christ Jesus, were baptized into his death.
然后到了第四节是与主同死同埋葬。
And in verse 4 it says, we were buried with him through baptism into death.
所以受洗是与主同死同埋葬。
So baptism is dying with Jesus and also being buried with him.
那个有罪的我。我们跟主耶稣在洗礼的时候，好像同钉十字架。
And my sinful self is also nailed to the cross, just like how Jesus was nailed.
然后全身入浸，跟主耶稣同埋葬。
And then your whole body is immersed, just like how you are buried with him.
然后从水里面上来，我们就跟主同复活。
And when you come back up from the water, that means that you are raised from the dead.
也就是那个死的原因，罪已经被洗掉了。
Which means that the reason for death, which is sin, has already been washed away.
所以死的咒诅就不存在，因为罪已经拿掉了。
So the curse of death is gone because the sin has been washed away.
所以我们从水里面上来，我们就得到永远的生命。
So when we rise from the water, that means that we have received everlasting life.
所以为什么洗礼这么重要？
So why is baptism so important?
因为主耶稣洗礼在洗礼的时候与主耶稣同死同埋葬，再来同复活。
Because during baptism, we are baptized into his death, and we are also buried, and we are raised from the dead.
那现在洗礼起来要怎么生活？
So now, after you are raised from baptism, how should you live your life?
因为洗礼是我们过去的罪全部都赦免了。
Because for baptism, during baptism, our old sins have been washed away.
所以还没有洗礼以前，罪做我们的主人，在控制我们。
So before baptism, sin is our master and it is controlling us.
那洗礼完这个罪已经死了。
So after baptism, this sin has died off.
我们从水里面上来是新人啊。
And we come up from the water and we are a new man.
那新人就要过新生活。
So this new man must live a new lifestyle.
那新生活是什么？
So what exactly is this new life?
好，我们现在回来看罗马书的第六章。
Let's take a look back at Romans chapter 6.
第六章的十一节。
Romans chapter 6, verse 11. Likewise, you also reckon yourselves to be dead indeed to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus our Lord.
我们向罪要看自己是死的。
So here it says, reckon yourselves to be dead indeed to sin.
也就是说，死就是说，我跟他没有关系啊，他已经死了。
So being dead to sin means that you have no relationship with it anymore.
但是向神在基督里要看自己是活的。
However, but alive to God in Christ Jesus our Lord.
我现在活着，我是新人，我是在基督里面。
When I am living and I'm a new man, that means that I am in God.
那有这样的了解接下去我们就看到十二节。
With this understanding, let's take a look at verse 12.
我们看罗马书第六章的十二节。
Romans chapter 6, verse 12. Verse 12. Therefore, do not let sin reign in your mortal body, that you should obey it in its lusts.
十三节。
Verse 13. And do not present your members as instruments of unrighteousness to sin, but present yourselves to God as being alive from the dead, and your members as instruments of righteousness to God.
十四节。
14. For sin shall not have dominion over you, for you are not under law, but under grace.
这个地方讲罪必不能够做你们的主。
So here it says that sin should no longer reign in your body.
因为你们是在神的恩典之下。
Because you are now under the grace of God.
因为我们向罪已经死了。
Because to sin we are dead.
但是我们到第七章的时候会讲圣灵。
However, when we reach chapter 7, we'll talk about the Holy Spirit.
当一个人被圣灵充满。
When someone is filled with the Holy Spirit,
渐渐就会跟神的性情有份。
Then they will start to draw a closer relationship to God.
在这个还没有达到这个情况之下，我们里面还是有罪性。
So before reaching this level, we actually still have a sinful nature.
那这个罪性有时候如果我们容让罪性来放纵，就会控制我们。
So if we don't control this sinful nature, then it will come to control us.
如果没有靠着圣灵的能力来致使罪性，罪性 会在控制我们。
If we don't rely on the Holy Spirit to put to death this sinful nature, then it will control us.
所以十二节在讲不要容罪在你必死的身上作王。
So here in verse 12, it says, therefore, do not let sin reign in your mortal body.
所以如果我们看13节
And if we look at verse
13 13节就在讲义跟罪
So in verse 13 it talks about righteousness and sin
那肢体肢体只是一个工具
And members which are our instruments
那真的控制一个人是里面的罪跟义
So what really controls someone is the conflict between righteousness and sin
为什么人会讲不好的话
So why do some people say bad things?
那不是他的嘴巴不好。
It's not that their mouth is bad.
是他里面有罪性。
But inside their hearts, they have a sinful nature.
为什么人会做不好的事？
Why do people do bad actions?
他不是他的手不好。
It's not that their hand is bad.
是他里面的罪在控制他。
But rather, they have a sinful nature controlling them.
为什么人的脚会去走罪的路？
Why do some people walk down the sinful road?
不是脚不好。
It's not that your feet are bad.
是他里面的罪性在控制他。
But rather, inside your heart, there is a sinful nature controlling you.
所以这个第六章就在提到我们受洗以后。
So in chapter 6, it talks about what happens after baptism.
我们要把我们的身体给义做器具。
Where we have to become, let our members as become instruments of righteousness to God.
所以我们洗礼以后注定是做奴仆啦。你如果不是做罪的奴仆，就是做义的奴仆。
So now that you are no longer under the control of sin, you are now under the control of righteousness.
如果我们洗礼罪已经洗干净了，再继续过罪的生活，结果是什么
？So after baptism, if we once our sins are washed away, but we continue back in that sinful way, what is our result?
好，我们也回来看罗马书的第六章。
Let's take a look at Romans chapter 6.
第六章的二十一节
，Chapter 6, verse 21. What fruit did you have then in the things of which you are now ashamed? For the end of those things is death.
这个地方讲罪到最后的结果就是死。
So here it says, for the end of those things is death.
所以我们受洗罪得赦免，是不是每个人都得永生呢？
So after baptism, once our sins are washed away, are we all guaranteed salvation?
这个完全是看，如果我们继续让罪控制我们，活在罪里面，到最后还是死。
This entirely depends on when we continue living on our lives, whether or not we let sin control us until we die.
那我们如果看二十二节。
So let's take a look at verse 22.
请。
Verse 22. But now having been set free from sin and having become slaves of God, you have your fruit to holiness and the end everlasting life.
二十三节。
23. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord.
所以这个地方讲如果我们让主耶稣来做我们的主人。
So here it says that if we let God become our master.
所以我们变成奴仆了。
So now we are slaves.
一生顺从他来带领。
So every day of our lives we submit to God.
我们在生活中就有圣洁。
Then in our lives, we will have this holiness.
那最后就是永生。
And afterwards, we will have everlasting life.
所以受洗过以后，不要继续活在罪里面。
So after baptism, we should not continue living in sin.
那圣灵会给我们力量。
Then the Holy Spirit will give us strength.
让我们能够克制罪的性。
So that we are able to withstand the control of the sinful nature.
那神性。充满我们罪性就越来越少。
So if we have the nature of God, then we will have less of the nature of sin.
我们来看一节彼得后书。
Let's take a look at 2 Peter.
啊，彼得后书的第一章。
2 Peter chapter 1.
啊，第四节。
Verse 4. By which have been given to us exceedingly great and precious promises, that through these you may be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust.
这第四节讲啊，他给我们又宝贵又极大的应许。
So in verse 4, it says that we have been given exceedingly great and precious promises.
啊，如果对世界上人一想到又宝贵又极大的应许，是不是主耶稣会祝福我在世界上成功成名啊，获利呢？
So in the worldly perspective, when we see great and precious promises, we might think, oh, is this success or a lot of wealth in this world?
哦，不是的。
It's not that.
这个宝贵啊，有很大的应许，不是钱买得到。
These exceedingly great and precious promises are not something you can buy with money.
这里讲脱离从情欲来的败坏。
Here it says to escape the corruption that is in the world through lust.
啊，情欲是什么？情欲就是罪性。
So what exactly is lust? This is the sinful nature.
啊，神要让我们脱离罪性。
And God wants to let us help us escape from the sinful nature.
那下面跟神的性情有份。
So that later we can have a part in God.
这个就是我们信仰生活努力的目标。
So this is the goal that we are all striving towards in our faith.
脱离罪性的捆绑，跟神性在神性里面得到丰盛。
To escape the control from the sinful nature to find abundance in God.
所以我们受洗 要努力什么？
So after we are baptized, what are we striving hard for?
就是要努力生命的更新。
We are striving to have this to be transformed in our lives.
那生命的更新是什么？
So what is the transformation of life?
脱掉罪性，好像旧衣服。
It is to take off the old man, like old clothes.
穿上新人。
And to put on the new man.
新人就是有神性。表现神性。
And the new man has godly characteristics.
好，我们可以来看，继续看一节哈，以弗所书。
Let's take a look at Ephesians.
以弗所书的第四章。
Ephesians chapter 4.
第四章的二十节。
Ephesians chapter 4, verse 20.
请。
Verse 20. But you have not so learned Christ.
21节。
21. If indeed you have heard him and have been taught by him, as the truth is in Jesus.
22节。
That you put off concerning your former conduct the old man which grows corrupt according to the deceitful lusts.
23节。
23. And be renewed in the spirit of your mind.
24节。
24. And that you put on the new man which was created according to God in true righteousness and holiness.
所以这二十节一直到二十四节，这是一生努力的功夫。
So from verses 20 to 24, this is a lifelong practice that we have to keep doing.
照着圣经的真理引导，在圣灵的帮助，我们将一直在改变。
So through the truth from Jesus and also the Holy Spirit, we are every day changing.
脱掉旧人，穿上新人。
So that you put off the old man and put on the new man.
如果用一个比喻来讲就是去年跟今年不一样。
So we can use an analogy, which is to compare our current self and the self we were a year ago.
明年跟今年会不一样。
And also to compare yourself now and compare yourself a year later.
那每一年都不一样，这个就是这个人一直在成长。
So if you notice changes every year, that means this person is growing.
所以我们的生命就越来越新了，跟主耶稣一样。
So that means that our life is more and more new, and we are more like Jesus.
那这个生命是在我们受洗的时候主耶稣赐给我们的。
And this is the life that we have received that that Jesus has given to us.
所以洗礼以后到底我们在追求什么？
So after baptism, what exactly are we trying to pursue?
脱去旧人，穿上新人。
To put off the old man and to put on the new man.
那我们现在看那个新人是24节。
So what is the new man? Let's look at verse 24.
有神的形象有真理的仁义跟圣洁。
The new man which was created according to God in true righteousness and holiness.
也就是还没有犯罪的亚当。
Which means that this was the Adam who had not sinned yet.
所以信仰生活的目标就是在追求这个。
So the goal in our lives, in our life of faith, is to pursue this sort of characteristic.
若有人在基督里，他就是新造的人。
If someone is in Christ, then he is a new man.
旧事已过，都变成新的。
All the former things have passed away, and all things have become new.
所以我们越努力我们这个人越像主耶稣。
So the more that we put in an effort, then the more we can become like Jesus.
那我们在神面前就得到越大的荣耀。
Then before God, we will obtain this greater glory.
好，那我们现在看哥罗西书。
Let's take a look at Colossians.
哥罗西书的第三章。
Colossians chapter 3.
第三章我们从第一节念到第四节。
We'll read verses 1 to 4. Verse 1. If then you were raised with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ is, sitting at the right hand of God. 2. Set your mind on things above, not on things on the earth. 3. For you died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. 4. When Christ, who is our life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory.
这个四节就在讲我们受洗的一种改变。
So these four verses talk about the change that we have after we're baptized.
第三节你们已经死了。
Verse 3 it says, for you died.
我什么时候死？
So when did I die?
受洗的时候。
That's when you were baptized.
我那个旧我、罪的我洗礼的时候已经死了。
My old sinful self has died during baptism.
那洗礼起来我们就活着，所以你们的生命与基督一同藏在神里面。
And after you get up from the water, then you are alive, and your life is hidden with Christ and God.
那这个生命很宝贵啊。
And this life is very precious.
第四节啊。
Verse 4.
他显现的时候，我们也要与他一同显现在荣耀里。
When Christ appears, then you will also appear with him in glory.
对我们来讲啊，这个物质世界才是真的。
So to us, this physical world is real to us.
灵界看不见，谁知道？
And the spiritual world is invisible, so who knows if it's real?
所以信耶稣啊，即使要求福气，也都是求地上的。
So when we're asking God for a blessing, sometimes we also ask for physical ones.
但是圣经的观念不是这样。
But the principle in the Bible isn't the same.
圣经的观念，这个世界是演一台戏。
The principle of the Bible says that our lives are just like a play.
一台戏只有两三个钟头啊。
And the play is only 2 to 3 hours long.
戏过去了就下台了。
And after the play is over, then and you're done acting, then you get off the stage.
这个物质世界有一天主耶稣来，全部都变成灰了。
Because Jesus says that this physical world one day it will all turn to dust.
但是我们看不见那灵界就会显现了。
But we cannot see this spiritual life that will soon show itself.
那个是真实的，我们就看得见。
And that is a real, life that we can see.
所以我们的信仰让我们活在这个暂时的物质界，但是盼望永远荣耀的灵界。
So our faith allows us to temporarily live in this physical world, but we will soon live in the spiritual world.
这都是因为我们洗礼的时候罪死了向神是活着。
And this is because we are baptized, our sinful nature is dead, and we are alive to God.
所以第三章告诉我们两件事情。
Chapter 3 tells us about three different things.
第二节要思念上面的事。
Verse 2 says to set your mind on things above.
不要思念地面上的事。
Not on things of the earth.
我们在洗礼的时候我们向神活，这个向世界来讲也是死的。
So when we were baptized, to God we were alive, but to the world they might see us as dead.
所以要思念上面的事。
Set your mind on things above.
上面就是神的事。
So things above means it's the things of God.
所以我们跟神的关系重新建立。
So our relationship with God has been rebuilt.
这是一个爱的关系。
And this is a relationship of love.
如果有爱，我们会常常想神。
If there's love, then you will continuously think about God.
所以我们的心会从地上往上提升。
So our hearts will be lifted from the earth into the heavens.
那么第一节哈。
Verse 1.
要求上面的事。
Seek those things which are above.
那里有基督坐在神的右边。
Where Christ is sitting at the right hand of God.
所以这个第三章就是在讲我们受洗之后要超越。
In chapter 3, it talks about after a baptism, we have to transcend.
我们人活在这个物质世界里面。
So as humans, we live in this physical world.
但是我们的心像老鹰一样超越地面的吸引，能够想神的事，追求神的事。
But our hearts must be uplifted like eagles, where it can transcend and see everything.
这就是我们属灵在追求的一个方向。
So this is the direction that we are pursuing in our journey of faith.
我们来看加拉太书第二章。
Let's take a look at Galatians chapter 2.
加拉太书第二章。
Galatians chapter 2.
二十节。
Verse 20. I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me.
二十节讲啊，我与基督同钉十字架。
So here in verse 20 it says, I have been crucified with Christ.
同钉十字架就是死了。
So to be crucified together means that you are dead.
那什么时候我跟基督同钉十字架？
So when was I crucified with Christ?
就是洗礼的时候。
That was the time when you were baptized.
洗礼的时候我归入主耶稣的死。
When you were, after baptism, you have gone with the death of Christ.
那现在活着不是我，乃是基督在我里面活着。
It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me.
因为我们里面有主耶稣的生命。
Because in us we have the we have this new life from Jesus.
所以我们一辈子就是一直追求主的生命在我们身上能够彰显出来。
So our entire lives we are trying to express the life of our Lord.
我们看腓立比书保罗的人生目标是什么。
Let's take a look at the book of Philippians to see what Paul's goal was.
二十一节，第一章二十一节。
Philippians chapter 1, verse 21. For to me to live is Christ, and to die is gain.
这里讲我活着就是基督。
So here it says, for me to live is Christ.
对每一个人来讲，没有信耶稣以前，我活着就是我自己。
So before we have believed in Christ, we might all think that to live is to do it for myself.
你认识我40年，你还不认识我吗？
You've known me for 40 years, but you don't really know the way I live.
我的个性从小到现在都一样。
My characteristics and my traits are all the same.
我的人生观就是赚钱快乐，到现在你还不认识我吗？
My goal in life is to be rich and be prosperous, and you still don't know what I am.
这个是人的理想。
But this is the ideas and logic of the world.
那我活着是基督。
So to live is Christ.
就是。我越来在一个人身上看到主耶稣的样式。
Which means that when you look at some person's life, you notice that they are more like Jesus.
所以在二十节这样说。
So in verse 20 it says this. Verse 20. According to my earnest expectation and hope that in nothing I shall be ashamed, but with all boldness as always, so now also Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death.
不论活着，不论死，保罗一个志向。
So whether by life or by death, Paul still had this idea.
要让基督在他的身上显当显扬出来。
That in his life he wanted to proclaim the life of Jesus.
就是让别人在他身上看到主耶稣。
Which is that when other people see him, they'll see the life of Jesus.
如果是这样。
If it is like this.
二十一节说，我死了就有益处。
Then in verse 21 it says, and to die is gain.
所以死绝对不虚空。
So dying is not something in vain.
为什么？
Why is that?
因为我活着就是基督。
Because for me to live, it is Christ.
唱诗。
I'll let us sing him.
398.
398.